two organs affected by statins on long-term treatment. What are the statins? So statins are the drugs which are used as anti-hyperlipidemic drugs, which decrease the LDL cholesterol and increase the HDL cholesterol in the blood. And as we know, LDL cholesterol is called as bad cholesterol and HDL cholesterol is called as good cholesterol. So statins are going to decrease the bad cholesterol and increase the good cholesterol within the blood. Now the drugs like simvastatin, lovastatin, pravastatin, rosuvastatin and atorvastatin, all these are called as statins. Now let us see common side effects of these statins. As with many category of drugs, statins also produce few of the common side effects like headache, neck stiffness, constipation, abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting, and dizziness in the patients. So this dizziness in the patient can also produce the lightheadedness in the patient, which can result in the falling sensation in the patient. But what are the specific side effects of the statins? So statins mainly affect the two important organs. One is the liver and second one is the muscle. Now let us see what are the effects of the statins on the liver and muscle on long-term treatment. First of all, let us see the effect on liver. So statins, again, they produce the anti-hyperlipidemic action by acting on the liver. So statins inhibit one of the key enzyme, HMG-CoA reductase enzyme, which is responsible for the biosynthesis of the cholesterol within the liver. So now this is the rate limiting enzyme in the biosynthesis of the cholesterol in the liver, which is targeted by statins. So when the statins are used for long-term treatment, we can observe an elevated levels of the liver enzymes. These elevated levels of liver enzymes can lead to the liver failure on long-term treatment. So whenever statins are given for a long-term treatment, we should check for the liver functionality tests. So two important enzymes are the ALT and AST. ALT is the alanine aminotransferase and AST, aspartate aminotransferase. So when the statins are used, these two enzyme levels are increased, which indicates the risk of the liver failure. So whenever statins are used for a long-term treatment, regularly the liver functionality test should be done. So it is suggested that for every 3 months, a liver functionality test can be checked to assess any risk of the liver failure. And effect on the metabolism by the liver. Liver is again one more important organ which is responsible for the metabolism of the drugs. So within the liver, one of the important enzymes is the cytochrome P450 enzyme. These are the group of enzymes which are responsible for the drug metabolism. So suppose if we going to take any drug along with the statins, now these drugs are going to be metabolized by cytochrome P450 system into their metabolites. Now statins are potent enzyme inhibitors. They inhibit the cytochrome P450, thereby they inhibit the metabolism of the various drugs that are taken along with the statins. So when other drugs are given along with the statins can increase their drug toxicity. So statins can precipitate so many important drug interactions. So whenever we are going to give the statins, we have to check for the drug interactions. And second organ which is affected by statins is the muscle. So now let us see effect on the muscle. So statins can produce muscle pain, muscle weakness, which results in the fatigue in the patients, myositis, that is the muscle inflammation. Because of this muscle inflammation, the serum creatine kinase levels may be increased in the patients treated with the statins. And finally, the statins can also produce the one of the condition, rhabdomyolysis, the dissolution of the muscle fiber, where the muscle fiber is slowly lost by use of these drugs. So now statins can produce one of the important side effect, rhabdomyolysis, and few of the other drugs like the fibrates can also produce the rhabdomyolysis. So fibrates are another category of antihyperlipidemic drugs which are acting mainly on the VLDL and triglyceride levels. Now when these two drugs are combined, there is more risk for the rhabdomyolysis. Normally the statins are not preferred with the fibrates, but whenever they have to be combined, the muscle functionality test should be done frequently such that the rhabdomyolysis can be checked in the patient. So these are the two organs on which statins produce very important effects on long-term treatment.